In the beginning, there was the NBA, and the basketball gods deemed there would be a selection of players by each team. This selection was deemed the draft, and from this draft brought forth players of varying talents. And so it was. The team from Philadelphia was rewarded with abundant wins and enough titles to count on three fingers. But a plague fell upon their house, and mediocrity took hold for many, many moons. And lo, there came a man short in stature, but tall in judgment. He spoke righteously of tanking, and of draft picks, and of mid-level exceptions. Through his reign, the darkness lasted for three revolutions of the earth around the sun, as players flourished or languished, had health or became infirm, or were simply banished. Yet one man refused to bow down to the conventional wisdom, and his work became known as the process. And woe unto him who doubted this process, as the powers that be cast him aside before it could be completed. And yet, this man's vision has been raised from the dead, reminding us all that he suffered for our sins. Last year, the Sixers almost tripled the number of wins from the previous year, and the lost pangs of hope began to stir through the streets of Philadelphia. And it all started by having a healthy Joel Embiid on the court. In a throwback to an era gone by, Embiid got most of his touches in the post, and he displayed a deft touch and great footwork down there, something we simply haven't seen from a player this young in a long, long time. Perhaps all that time off gave him a chance to refine his moves into a cornucopia of face-ups, spins, and hooks. And it didn't matter how good his man was, he was able to have his way against anyone who tried to stop him down low. And it's this type of gravity that will open up everything for his teammates. And now that there's more talent spread around, his kickouts will lead to easier scores all around. Teams that foolishly double down one pass away will have to be willing to give up open shots from simple kickouts from Embiid, who showed the ability to find the open man when the defense bumped down to harass him. Embiid is also of the modern era a big man, someone who can pick and pop for the three ball at an above average rate, making him the kind of player that eventually will be utterly unstoppable when the defenses can't find a spot on the floor to give him shots. And it's the pick and roll with Embiid that I'm convinced will create so many more open shots for his teammates that the collective field goal percentage will rise accordingly. You can see how much focus the defense gives to Embiid on his rolls to the hoop, and how that, in turn, will open up things for Stauskas, Saric, Fultz, and Covington. While on the subject of pick and roll, I want you to picture Markelle Fultz in the TJ McConnell role in the offense for a little bit. I know, it might be hard, but it should also be clear that Fultz has 10 times more ability from an athletic standpoint, and he can also shoot the ball much better than McConnell, making him a harder guard for the defenses. So if you combine Fultz and Embiid in the pick and roll, everything gets much easier for everybody else. Not only can Fultz excel in the pick and roll with his extraordinary athletic ability and polished finishing game, he can also be a spot-up wing player who can catch and shoot when Ben Simmons is out there running the pick and roll. While Simmons will no doubt struggle from the outside, at his size and quickness, he'll have the ability to simply collapse defenses from the perimeter. And I haven't seen a player this young with court vision like this since, I don't know, maybe Magic Johnson. He has a good balance between finding the right pass and making the spectacular one, And if the Sixers want to play him alongside Fultz in the backcourt, he should have no problem being able to see over any guard the defense puts on him. And if they try to defend him with a big man, we'll get treated to his unorthodox drives that result in some of the strangest right hand finishes I have seen. While he was forced to shoot lefty from the outside at an early age, it seems clear to me he is a natural right-handed player, and I'm curious to see if these awkward, twisty shots with the right will go down against NBA defense. But that doesn't factor in his ability in the open court as well. The Sixers will want to play as fast as possible, and it's simply mouthwatering to imagine Simmons grabbing the board and pushing the ball with shooters and cutters filling the lanes ahead of him. While his vision in the half court is tremendous, it's in the full court where we get the most Magic Johnson comparisons, and this is what will make them so much fun to watch next year. Fultz not only showed that he can dominate with the ball in his hands, but as a complement in the offense as a spot-up playmaker. His jumper is pretty, he's got solid range, and when the closeout comes, he can put the ball on the floor and create something with either hand. A level of skill and power and balance that is unique to someone so young, and why he will be picked first in the draft. Fultz and Simmons could easily play off each other, taking turns controlling the offense, although I suspect Simmons will get more run on the ball since Fultz is so much better as a shooter off the ball. But it's not just Simmons with a tremendous vision. Dario Saric displayed some of the flashiest passing from the power forward position in the NBA. Which will serve to encourage cutters from all over the floor to move to get open, knowing, more often than not, they'll get a great, crowd-pleasing pass that sets them up for an easy bucket. In some weird version of the Matrix, the Sixers could find a place to use Jahlil Okafor off the bench as a scoring spark down low, a guy who can get them 12 points and 7 rebounds, and if he accepted his role, perhaps a little more energy on the defensive end. Since the Sixers aren't deep enough yet, they're in the market to bring in at least one more veteran to add to this nucleus of Embiid, Simmons, Fultz, and Saric. And if they can pull off a good fit amongst this group, then the days of tanking would certainly be over, with the Sixers making a serious run at the playoffs this year. It also puts a lot of pressure on Brett Brown to do that coaching thing, since it's time to make a dent in his career coaching record with more wins than losses. And yay, as we walk through the valley of the shadow of Hinkie, we will fear no Pistons, no Bulls, no Cavaliers. For the team once led by Moses to the Promised Land has a shepherd guiding them from above, one whose process revealed the cup that runneth over, and a team destined to live long and prosper.
For Covington! With 2/10 of a second to go!
Sports fans, to see more of our great NBA content and analysis, make sure to hit the subscribe button, but also click the bell and adjust your settings so you can get an alert the second our videos drop. Because trust me, you're going to want them hot and fresh. You in?